Trade Ministry Permanent Secretary appeared before the Anti-Corruption Court in Kampala yesterday to answer charges of alleged corruption and abuse of office. Sally was arrested yesterday shortly after she turned up at the Criminal Investigation Directorate in Kampala and was charged alongside three members of parliament, Michael Mawanda, the Igara East MP, Mudimi Wamakuyu, Elgon County Member of Parliament. Others on the charge sheet are Paula Kamba, the Busiki County Member of Parliament, Leonard Kavundida, the Assistant Register of Cooperatives in the Ministry of Trade, and lawyer Julius Kiria, after the state amended their earlier charges. The prosecution led by Edward Mohomoza informed the court that they had completed their investigations. However, the defense lawyers applied for bail.
I am on record having informed the courts that inquiries were completed. However, Your Worship, on the 9th of July 2024, there was an application by the accused persons to be released on bail.
He read out the amended charge sheet, which amounted to seven charges, including causing financial loss to the government, abuse of office, money laundering, conspiring to steal government funds meant for Buyeka Cooperative Society. The lawyers, led by Mwesiga Rukutana, Caleb Alaka, and Evans Ocheng, objected to the amendments made to the charge sheet by the prosecution, saying it was illegal and against the human rights of the accused.
Under Section 132(1)(a) of the MCA, knowing very well the section is inapplicable, just to defeat these people's right to apply for bail.
My Lord, in summary, is that if a court can try, then it can grant bail. And my Lord, you will look at the reasoning in that decision that they have punished.
The prosecution stated that the court did not have jurisdiction over the case of money laundering as a charge for A4. According to the charges, Mawanda, Wamakuyu, Akamba, Kiria and Kavundira conspired to defraud 7.3 billion shillings, which was meant for compensation of Buyeka Growers Cooperative Society Limited. The charges were allegedly committed between 2019 and 2023. The hearing was adjourned until tomorrow. The accused were sent back on remand. Geraldine Sally was taken to the Criminal Investigation Department head office for further questioning. While circumcision is a religious practice for some, for others, it is a scientifically proven technique to reduce HIV infection and sexually transmitted infections, STIs. In advance of the inaugural Imbalu ceremony slated for 3rd August, the Minister of Health and the Cultural Institution in Zuyama Masaba have announced that over 45,000 registered surgeons will have to undergo HIV tests to safeguard those to be circumcised. The chairperson of surgeons in the Bugisu Cultural Institution, Majid Mudebo, stated that local surgeons in Bugisu will be coercively tested for HIV this year before being allowed to conduct circumcision, and those found HIV positive will be barred from participating while their privacy shall be protected. Mudebo also lamented that the lack of protective gear by surgeons during circumcision exposes them to HIV and other diseases. According to Mudebo, since 2012, there has been a policy in place codenamed One Knife, One Candidate to clean and sterilize knives during circumcision. According to Article 37 of the Ugandan Constitution, which states that Ugandans have the right to practice and enjoy cultural languages and traditions. At the same time, the International Convention on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, Ugandans have the right to the highest attainable standard of health. He noted that these two rights do not oppose each other because promoting health rights should be integrated with cultural practices. Building strong policy at the intersection of health and culture practice can be complex. However, this means lost business and livelihood for surgeons who are living with HIV. President Volodymyr Zelensky said all 95 Ukrainian freed were from the military and thanked the UAE for its help. Russia's defense ministry, in a statement, said the returning soldiers would receive medical examinations and physical and psychological rehabilitation. It said the freed troops had faced mortal danger in Ukrainian captivity. The prisoner exchange was the third over the past 7 weeks, with the first announced at the end of May. Kyiv has secured the return of 3,405 people from Russian captivity since the start of Russia's invasion in February 2022, the Ukrainian Coordinating Committee on Dealing with Prisoners of War said. It said 7 officers and 88 soldiers and sergeants were freed, and most had been in captivity since 2022. This is the biggest swap between the two sides in almost 5 months, according to officials. Moscow and Kyiv have carried out over 50 prisoner exchanges since Russia started its offensive more than 2 years ago, despite ongoing hostilities and both sides accusing each other of derailing talks.